Good morning. I wanted to just do a do your makeup with me tutorial today. I hadn't been on here in about a week, and my sunburn is finally gone. So now I've just got some freckles I need to cover up, and my color has changed a bit. So I'm actually, as of right now, mixing my candlelit with my wheat because I'm not quite with candlelit anymore, but I'm not quite to amber yet. So this morning I'm going to use my Buffy brush, and I've got my candlelit and my wheat that I'm mixing together. And I always do my highlight first. I mean, it's preference. You can actually do your contour first if you want to. And I usually always start on my forehead. It's kind of a given. And actually, I'm not even going to stop this video and restart it because I didn't put on my stay spray. I used my moisturizer last night, but I want to do my stay spray this morning. As a matter of fact, let me get this mop out of my face so that I can do this properly. All right, a little bit of stay spray. Because I really don't have time for it to sit and soak in, I use my Perfector sponge to just kind of get that going and get it set where I need it. Now that the rain has finally stopped, it's getting a little bit warmer outside, so I definitely want to use my stay spray. All right, back into my highlight. All righty. And I don't swipe because it seems to go on so much better by pressing it in and what they call stippling, which I know I've said that before. So, and plus I go back and I use my Perfector sponge to kind of make sure that this all goes in evenly, but stippling makes it so much easier to go on. I've noticed if I'm swiping, I have to go back and basically stipple over where I've swiped to give it an even layer. The thing about Mascara Beauty is it is all of these products are interchangeable. I mean, I have seen girls that just do, their bronzer with their highlight. I mean, for like their lips, their eyes, their cheeks, everything, their contour, and it look amazing. Contour is used for eyeliner and eyebrows and lip liner. I've actually been using my Ash contour as my lip liner. I mean, there's really nothing bad to say about this makeup. I have never been a big makeup person until I started using Mascara Beauty, and it's because after seeing so many photos of the look I had with my powder makeup, I realized there was something bad wrong. And I realized that it was an old look. It was probably the same look that I used when I was in high school. And it just made me look so much older, and I started kind of doing some studying on what I could do differently. And, I found out that, powder tends to sit in creases of your face and lines and that kind of thing, and it tends to show up a lot better in your lines and your creases than a cream foundation. And I also used to use liquid, and liquid tends to dry and crack in your lines and creases. The one thing about mascara is made with it's a wax based instead of a silicone based. And the wax tends to just kind of melt into your skin. It makes it like a second skin, pretty much. Even though it is still allergy season and my eyes are so red, we're going to try to make that go away. All right, I have basically just put my foundation coverage on, which is, like I said, I mixed my candlelit and my wheat because I've had a little bit of sun. And then once I get that coverage on, I like to swap over to my detail hack brush to do my contour. This one here, this end is fabulous. And right now I am using Ash, and I just kind of dip that in there, and I try to get both sides of it. And I like to start right at the ear and press up into that jawline. You want to kind of give yourself, you're giving yourself a shadow with a contour. And I usually try not to go past my eye right here. And if I do, I try to bring it back a little bit. Of course, you can always go back in and fix this. This is so buildable, so universal. It's a very fixable, buildable, workable makeup. I always contour my forehead. Up here's where I've proceeded to get the freckles from being in the sun a little too much. And I don't really prefer to lay in the sun. I don't do the tanning bed anymore. I've had too many people that are close to me have some skin cancer issues, and it's a little scary, especially whenever they're your mother and it's that close to your bloodline. You kind of want to be careful. So I became a self-tanner freak. Currently, I've been using, I believe, Skinny Tan is probably my favorite right now. It's a foam with a mitt, and it goes on so good you can actually see where it goes when you put it on. And then I actually have tanning drops by Isle of Paradise. I put two drops in my moisturizer when I put my moisturizer on to kind of bronze my face a little bit. And speaking of bronzing, I'm actually going to use my Bella bronzer today because I haven't used my tanning drops since I had my little sunburn. All right, so now I'm going to go to my, whoops, I dropped it as usual, my Blend Forever brush. And I use this kind of pointy dense end to highlight my nose. I just rub that in my contour, or contour my nose, I'm sorry. And I kind of have this lumpy, fat little nose. And you want to do a parallel line, and I always go up to my eyebrow. Different strokes for different folks, whatever works for you, you'll find what works for you. And I just do a really light contour, and then I just kind of bring that down. Once again, contour is a shadow. Remember, we're not trying to look like we have a dirty nose. We're just trying to cast that shadow to give it some contour. And then I do the same thing right here, just to kind of contour my lip a little bit. All right. So now that I've done that, I just kind of go back in, darken this up a little bit before I use my Perfector sponge. Don't be afraid to go a little dark with the contour. I hear a lot of people say that they tend to lose their contour in what they're doing with their makeup. And I think it's because a lot of people are afraid to go as dark as they should so that they don't lose it. All right. And now I've gotten to where I use my Perfector sponge and my stay spray before I do my blush because I've noticed that I'm starting to lose my blush a little bit whenever I do that. So I take the butt end and I just kind of start pressing. You don't ever want to swipe, you just want to press. With this cream product, you want to press it into your skin. Like I said earlier, you basically want to make it a second skin. I like to press up into my cheekbone where I did that contour on my cheekbones. Same thing with my chin. I like to press up, then I'll flip it around to do my neck and get right in my chin. And in the corner of my nose and right underneath my eyes. That helps to pick up any extra product that you may have gotten in those lines and those creases that tend to show up a little bit more than we want. All right, so now, excuse me, I'm going to go to my B squared bronzer and blush brush, and I am going to actually, I usually do nude, but I think today I am going to try something different. And I'm not trying to stick my finger in my new blush. So I think today I am going to try our new Tropicana. This is one of our newer blushes. This is just a little sample size that I had gotten, but it is such a pretty color and everybody seems to be in love with it. It's got that nice peachy tint to it. And they've used a new formula, so it's really creamy and it really goes on really, really well. Like you don't need much. And you just kind of want to stipple that on there, just like you did your contour or your highlight and your contour. And I always put mine right above my contour. It's a good summer color. Called Tropicana. Good summer name, even. And then today, I think I'm actually even going to just dab a little bit on my eyes to kind of give my eyeshadow a base. Because this is such a pretty color and it goes on so well. Right, and then I am going to go into my eyeshadow palette, go straight into it. I'm gonna go back to my Blend Forever brush, or Blend Everything brush, my bad, because I love this end here. And I am going to go into Oak right here. I really like Oak. It's not too dark, it's not too light, it's very pigmented. So once I kind of just tap that brush into that, I just kind of tap it on the end here, and I'm going to use this basically as my blend color. I'm going to put that in that crease. I'm just going to get it in there really good. It doesn't have to be perfect because we're going to make this all come together. And I brush just a little bit of excess underneath my eye. So I'm going to do the other side. Like I said, remember these are really, really pigmented. You get 2.5 grams per square, which is more than what you get in most. And let me tell you, it does not take much. These last forever. I have got one called Cupcake and, well, two, and Lullaby that I have been using since February, and they barely even have a dent in them. These last so long. All right, so next I'm actually going to go into, I believe it is called You Complete Me, or this is Peppa. Nope, this is Peppa. Let's go with Peppa today. Because Peppa's kind of got that look to kind of go with the Tropicana a little bit. Peppa's really pretty. It's got a little bit of a shimmer to it. Once again, very pigmented. And I'm going to go right above. I have hooded eyelids. So this is kind of a little tip for those of you who have hooded eyelids. Leave your eye open and hold that brush at the end. And just kind of hit where you know you can see it. Because when you close your eye, you tend to go down. And then when you open your eye, you kind of start to lose it a little bit. Okay, I'm going to the other side. I'm just going right above that Oak. I'm kind of blending the two together a little bit. All right, and then I'm going to go into Sabrina, and I'm just going to just dab a little bit right there in the corner. You know, they say there's a time to press and a time to swipe. I'm just kind of pressing that Sabrina in the corner of my eye. And then You Complete Me is one of my favorites. It's kind of got a glimmer too. I just press that right in the center of my eyelid. Just pressing that on there. Okay. So I did Tropicana kind of as my base, Oak in my crease. I did Peppa on top, Sabrina in the corners, and then You Complete Me right on the lid. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to dip back in my Oak just one time. Really knock that off there. Go back into my crease again to where I may have lost a little bit of that. Okay, back in my crease again. Make sure I really get this outer corner to kind of give it some definition. And then this is kind of where the magic happens. I'm just going to blend. I'm going to blend, 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 blend. I tried to just go, I try to kind of skip the lid a little bit in the center. I go from the corner all the way to that outer edge. Because I don't really want to lose that little bit of You Complete Me I put on there. And I just want to blend that out. Just to give me some a little bit of color, a little bit of definition. So you can still see where that Oak is here, the You Complete Me. All right. Then I like to go back to my Buffy brush on the end that I used for my contour, and I just, or my highlight, and I just kind of get some of that excess out from underneath my eyes. All right, today I'm actually going to use my CoverGirl Perfect Blend eyeliner instead of using Cola. I usually use Cola mascara, but because or mascara product, which is a contour, but because my eyes are a little irritated this morning, it seems like when I use the brush to put the Cola on, it seems like it irritates my eyes a little bit more. So I'm just going to use my pencil. I do my outer corner on my top lid, and then I do the waterline on the bottom. I really don't know if holding your mouth open helps, but I do it. And then I do the waterline in the upper corner. All right. And then I flip that over to the little blend. And I'll blend out and in. I don't go all the way to my inner corner just for the simple fact that I'm trying to stay away from having the gooped up black in the corner of my eye. So I go out and then I come back in. Everybody has their own preference. I'm just basically telling you what I'm doing as I'm doing it. Okay. Once again, Buffy brush. Any excess off there. I just barely tap. Alright, and then before I put on my actual mascara, I'm going to go to my Benefit Brow Contour Pen, and I go to the deeper shade. It's just like a little twisty thing, the cool little pens that we loved in high school. And I'm just going to define this brow a little bit. I need to go get them waxed, so I'm not even going to lie there. I'm in a desperate need for a waxing on these eyebrows. So today I'm just basically going to wing it and do the best I can. No shame in my game as far as my eyebrows go. I'm not about perfect eyebrows. It is what it is. I'm kind of in the process of even trying to get them to grow in a little bit fuller where I've overplucked or whatever. I've actually stopped plucking my eyebrows because I do always overpluck. So I'm just giving that a little bit of an outline and a little bit of a fill-in because now I am going to go to my Benefit again, Gimme Brow. It's like a little mini mascara brush. And when my eyebrows get this bad, like when I really need to get them plucked, this is the best thing because not only does it kind of tame them into going in the right direction, but it fills them as well in the areas. Ooh, I'm just dropping things all over the place today. In the areas that need to be filled. You know, if my brows are cooperating, and see, I've done made a mess. Which, you know, is typical. I'll probably make a mess with my mascara too. I tend to do that quite often. And what I do for that situation is a simple Q-tip. Just go right underneath it and just kind of clean it up a little bit. And then I will kind of show you a trick that I've learned just here recently, which a lot of people highlight underneath their brows. But I have learned that, especially if I need mine plucked, this Brow Benefit pen actually has a highlighter option on it. And I'll go in and I will just highlight right at that line, maybe where, you know, you can really tell that I need some cleanup going on with these brows. And then once I get that on there, I will actually take my eyeshadow everything brush, which is my all-time fave, and I just bring that down. I just kind of cover the areas of kind of where you can tell where I need some serious cleanup on my brows. It kind of helps to cover the little hairs that need to be waxed out, that kind of thing. All right, now for mascara. Right now, I am actually using this new one by Too Faced. It kind of goes back to the old school big fat brush, which I really like. And I like to do my bottom lashes first. For the simple fact that I have hooded eyes. And if I do my top ones first, whenever I go down to do my bottom, I tend to look up way too much and get it all over my upper lid. So, another good tip for hooded eyes, get that bottom lash line first, move to the top. Because it does tend to help not be so messy. And I am such a messy mascara person. I think it's just because I try to do it too quickly. But it's the truth. I'm very messy. I always try to get right at that waterline and push up. I'm not big on curling my eyelashes. I feel like I have this fear of one day, you know, like my eyelashes just coming off in the eyelash curler. I've never heard of that happening, but you know, you never know. My luck, I would be the one it would happen to. And I get right at that lash line and I just push them up and I kind of hold them for a second. right. Brighten those eyes up quite a bit. So I use Tropicana as my blush color and even on my eyes, but I think I'm actually, well, let me go ahead and line my lips. I may go ahead and use Tropicana as my lips. I will actually go to my Know Your Angles brush, which also has the eyebrow brush on the end, which I love. I usually always go over my brows. I meant to do that while ago. And then I will dip back into my contour, which is ash, on both sides of the little angled brush on the end. And actually give myself a little bit of lip liner. This brush is fantastic for a lot of things. Nose contour, lip liner. If you're really wanting to get a good, you know, brow, this is your brush. Because let me tell you, I have used the eyeshadows for my brows. I have used shadow contour for my brows. They all work fabulous. And the Know Your Angles brush is exactly that. It helps you know your angles. It gets right in there and does exactly what it's supposed to do. And after I line, I just kind of get a little bit and I start bringing it down onto my lip and up on the bottom. Just enough to kind of give me a line. Now, I think I'm gonna go into my back into my Tropicana lip and cheek. These are such a good combination of whatever they use. They're so creamy. So they work really well for a blush and they look fabulous on your lips. It's almost like a lip color with the gloss built in already, which you know I know a lot of girls look for. And my lips feel amazing after I use it. Absolutely amazing. I don't feel like I need any kind of chapstick or lip gloss or anything of that matter. Go back in. And line a little bit more. All right. At this point in time, if you tend to be a little oily or you feel like maybe you're going to be, you know, in the heat a little more on a certain day or whatever, this would be the time that you would want to use your powder. I usually use Coty Airspun translucent powder or this powder. Now, one of the things that I have started doing since I've started using my vanilla dust powder is I will take my Perfector sponge and I will just wipe it in to the vanilla dust powder, and then I will just actually press it into places that I know I tend to get oily, because this will lighten you up a little bit. And I don't actually put it all over my face. Like, I don't have to worry about brushing it off. And that's it. That's all I do. That's all the powder that I use. I don't go crazy with it. All right. And last but not least, I am going to use my Angel Illuminator. And I take that, I just do it on my pinky. You can actually, a lot of the girls, and so do I, most of the time, I'll use my Best Blend Forever brush, the BBF. Matter of fact, I'll just go ahead and do that. And I take the smaller end and I just tap it into my illuminator. Angel is a cream. We do have powders. Matter of fact, I just got Glamorizing, which is a powder, and or Glamorize, and it is fantastic. I go right beneath the brow, right above the edge of the brow. This just kind of lightens you up a little bit, gives you that little bit of, you know, shine, sparkle, whatever you want to call it, brightness. And then I take the bigger end and roll it around in there, and I just drag it right across the top of that blush. I don't go crazy with the illuminator at all. Some do, I don't. Then I'll take the small end again and I'll just tap it right in the places on my lips that I just kind of want to give it a little bit of shine. All right, ladies, that's it. That's pretty much my morning routine. I know I've been on here for like 25 minutes, but I've also been doing a lot of talking, but it's simple, simple. Mascara Beauty is, like I said, I would have never, ever seen myself doing this until I started realizing my skin looked so tired. Right now, my hair is so frizzy. And I needed a change. I mean, my skin was wore out more than I was. So I looked into Mascara Beauty. I love their Milk skincare line. I exfoliate twice a week with their exfoliator. I use my Milk moisturizer every night. I use the cleanser every night. I tone once or twice a week. It's been the best thing ever. I have quit using anything else besides my retinol and that kind of thing. Their makeup has made my skin so much better. I mean, I can wipe my makeup off and my skin doesn't look tired anymore. It looks quenched. You know, your face is kind of the most thirsty thing on your body. It is exposed to everything. So if anybody is interested in being color matched or taking a look at the products, or if anybody's interested in being an artist, which is amazing. It's an amazing program with a bunch of amazing women. I will put my link in the bio and my email. You're more than welcome to get a hold of me. And if you'd like to be color matched, please, you know, message me on here or shoot me an email. Or you can even come over to my Finding Fabulous page and message me over there. So my name is Beth. And if you have any questions, feel free. I wouldn't be sharing this if I didn't love it. I never would have got into this. And I'm never going to tell you that something is great that it's not. If I don't like something, like I used to not like the vanilla dust powder, I'd tell all my girls until I really gave it a try and I realized I was missing out. So I'm just going to be straightforward with you all the time. And Mascara Beauty is coming out every day. I heard a little birdie that we may possibly be actually getting mascara. They have changed up some of the combinations with the eyeshadows. We actually have one right now that is a creamy eyeshadow. So there's something new all the time. We're on the ground floor. They're building. Cara Brooke has done an amazing job. So stay tuned because mascara is definitely going to grow and it is the best thing that's ever happened to my skin. So thank you again.